The garden on Stone Street continues to grow. What started as a fruit and vegetable patch has grown to include herbs, flowers, and wildlife in an effort to create a backyard food forest in the City of Angels.
One way to be successful as a gardener is to encourage and provide space for easy-to-grow plants. Every fall before the first rains, we go out and spread sunflower seeds, cilantro seeds, and whatever else we have. The seeds have been harvested and gathered from the previous year's plants, going on 5 years now. Spreading them before a storm helps ensure that they get enough water to help them germinate and grow through the winter and into the spring. We don't water them because the soil is moist from all the winter rains. This season we've gotten about 16 inches of rain. The cilantro turns to coriander, the seeds that we will save for the next season.
During the winter and early spring months, we get plenty of volunteer lettuce. The lettuce will produce leaves, then bolt, flower, and produce seeds. The seeds are left to spread and bring lettuce plants the following winter. In a similar way, nasturtiums have been able to naturalize themselves in different parts of the garden. The clusters get bigger each year. Nasturtium flowers and leaves are edible.
We've learned to appreciate the insects in the garden. We've noticed how insects play an important role. Although our beehives are now empty, the bees buzz around, pollinating the flowers from the vegetables, fruits, and herbs. Ladybugs live on leaves, eating aphids. Butterflies add beauty and color while pollinating flowers around the garden. And grasshoppers nibble on leaves and become food for the birds that would otherwise eat fruits from the trees.
Other plants that are naturalized or are easy to grow are arugula, chickweed, dandelion, tomatoes, squash, mallow, and beans. Sometimes you'll get a small fruit tree to grow from a seed that was thrown in the ground.
So, don't hesitate to throw a seed in the ground because you'll never know what will grow.